Hi friends, today I'm going to show you how I cut these three names. The first name I'm going to be making is Destiny. As usual, I will not be speeding up or slowing down my video. I will be starting with the number 5 Flying Dutchman scroll reverse blade. The wood I'll be using today is 1x4 pine. I sanded my board, I put blue painter's tape on it, I spray glued my pattern and attached it to the board. Then I drilled holes so that my blade can go through. I always start with my inside cuts. As you can see, I've already drilled and scrolled the D. Now I'm about to scroll the bottom of the inside of the name. This is how I make my nameplates. Make sure you hold your wood down really well. If you don't hold your wood down, you'll get what the scroll saw community calls chatter. That is when your blade picks up your wood and it bangs it against your table and it makes this really awful sound. I'm going to stay quiet for a little while and let you guys watch my hand placement as I scroll. I'll be back when we're about to do a spinny do. This is where we're going to do our spinny do. I'm going to scroll into this corner. You see it's really sharp, so we're going to keep it sharp. After I scroll in, I'm going to spin around, back in there, and then I'll continue to scroll. This makes it look really neat. This makes sure that you can't tell where you started or stopped. Here I'm showing how I cut the bottom part of my name. What I usually do is go ahead and cut straight across the bottom, leaving that butterfly attached. That way, when it's time to cut the butterfly, I will have more wood to hold on to. In another part of this video, I'm going to show you what happens when you don't cut straight across the bottom and you cut your butterfly out first. I'm about to cut out the butterfly for this name. As you can see, I have a lot of wood to hold on to. This makes sure that I don't have to have my fingers so close to the blade when I'm cutting, and it gives me a lot more leverage As I said in another part of the video, I'm going to show you what it's like to actually not have all of that wood to hold on to. I'm back. So after cutting that, I'm going to go ahead and peel the tape off of the name Destiny. If you don't want to watch this process, fast forward a little to the next name. The next name I'll be cutting is Jaya. In this part of the video, I will show you the difference between leaving your butterfly to be cut with a big piece of wood attached to it or just cutting your butterfly out first. Let me know what you think about the difference, which one you liked better. Don't forget to let me know which one you liked better, cutting out the butterfly with a big piece of wood attached, or cutting out the butterfly by itself with very little to hold on to. Well, before I start every project, I go ahead and I wipe the dust away from the table. If not, you will end up beveling your project, meaning one side will be bigger than the other. The next name I'll be cutting is DJ with a puppy on the end of it. Thank you for joining me while I cut these three names. Until the next video, happy scrolling!